Welcome back to the RM Network. Today we will be talking about Peter Quill and that one thing that he did in Avengers Infinity War. That is a spoiler warning. If you have not seen Avengers Infinity War by now, please turn this video off, go see it, and then come back to this video. Alright, let's begin. Peter Jason Quill was abducted from Earth in 1988 after having watched his mother pass away from a devastating battle with cancer. He never knew his father, and we'll get back to that, and was raised by Yondu and Danta and this band of Ravagers, afraid that at any second, the Ravagers would eat him. Let's just say he didn't have the best role models growing up. In 2014, Peter met his soon-to-be love interest Gamora, daughter of the mad Titan Thanos, along with the rest of his new family, the Guardians of the Galaxy. 4 months later, Peter and the Guardians met his father, Ego, a living planet. All seemed right with the world until we discovered that Ego had put the tumor in the brain of Peter's mom. His own father had betrayed him, killed his mother, and wanted to use him to conquer the universe. Peter absolutely freaks out and tries to kill his father, as most people would in such a scenario. His father killed his mother, one of the two people that Peter loves. Peter eventually defeats Ego, but little did he know that his only real father figure in life, Yondu, would die saving his life. Skip ahead 4 years. The Guardians are doing their thing, when all of a sudden, they're called back into action as Thor tells him that Thanos is after the Infinity Stones. Gamora then pulls Peter aside and tells him that if Thanos captures her, she wants him to kill her. That's a lot for anybody to hear, but it's especially rough for someone who has so little. When the Guardians arrive on Nowhere, Thanos does capture Gamora and she pleads with Peter to pull the trigger. He eventually does, only for Thanos to not allow her death. Let's take a moment to think about that. Peter, after having just lost his mother and his father figure, is now asked by his girlfriend to kill her. After much hesitation, he finally does, thinking he has sacrificed her, but instead, nothing happens. Peter now carries that burden with him for the rest of the movie. He has to live with the fact that he was willing to kill the love of his life. Now for the controversial part. On Titan, when the team has Thanos trapped and are trying to pull off the gauntlet, Peter learns that Thanos has killed Gamora. Peter begs Thanos to tell him it's not true, and then proceeds to wail him with punches, releasing him from his disabled state, allowing him to take the gauntlet and win. Now, is it really so ridiculous to believe that Peter would act as what we as the audience see as erratic? Would you not do the same thing in this situation? The man lost his mother to his father, killed his father, which inadvertently killed his adopted father, and now he's hearing that his girlfriend he nearly killed himself was killed by her father, who stands in front of him, and we as an audience want him to react like he has no feelings at all? We would all lose our shit in that situation. Let's not forget that Peter was raised by a group that probably didn't teach him many manners. Peter's only real fault in this movie was that he acted like any other human would. While I'm not saying that Peter shouldn't have taken a moment to consider the possibilities, what he did was totally within his character and showed us the most human side of him we've ever seen. Now it's time for your guys' thoughts. What did you think of Peter's reaction in Infinity War, and would you have changed it if you could? Let me know all of that in the comments section, and make sure if you enjoyed this video you like and subscribe to the channel. My Instagram and Twitter, as well as the channels, will be linked in the description box, and as always, thank you guys so much for watching. I'll see you next time.